Welcome to another edition of Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am the host, Sean Anthony, the motivator, and I want to start by introducing my guest. Miss Sophia Stewart received her Bachelor of Arts degree in journalism and minors in law and psychology at City University of New York. And while attending the university, she studied under the guidance of many celebrated authors and writers. In 1979, she moved from New York to Los Angeles, where she studied cinema at the University of Southern California. It was there where she had the opportunity to study film under producer Leon Roth, who is the father of Eric Roth, screenwriter of the movie Forrest Gump. She is an accomplished award-winning poet who has published over 100 poems. She also received the Rosa Parks Award, and in 2007, she was nominated for the international award called Lifting Up the World with a Oneness Heart. And some of the individuals that received this prestigious award were Nelson Mandela, Mikhail Gorbachev, Mother Teresa, Pope John Paul, Jesse Jackson, and many others. Mother of the Matrix, as she is affectionately known, wrote her epic, The Third Eye, while she was studying cinema at the University of Southern California. Her work was copyrighted since 1981, which is the foundation and contains the core elements of the blockbuster films The Terminator and The Matrix. Stewart's brilliance lies in her ability to create characters, stories, and cinematic magic. And in The Third Eye, she has transformed comprehensive metaphysical and spiritual concepts in the most revered science fiction films of the 20th century. The Terminator and The Matrix films are among the most artistically phenomenal and financially profitable film franchises in Hollywood's history. These works have currently grossed over $25 billion, 4 Oscars, and continue to generate revenue internationally. She is currently continuing her epic work in the upcoming Matrix 4 movie, which is destined to supersede the extraordinary success of The Matrix and The Terminator and establish her as one of the most profound master writers in the 21st century. I want to welcome for the first time to Flow of Wisdom Radio, Miss Sophia Stewart. Good to have you.
Oh, yes, thanks. Thank you guys for inviting me to your show today, and really appreciate it.
Yeah, I definitely appreciate the time as well. First, let's talk about these legal battles that you've been going through. Your book that you wrote, well, actually, it was, and correct me if I'm wrong, was it a treatment for the movie The Third Eye, where the movies The Terminator and The Matrix pretty much had a lot of core elements in those films from your story?
Well, actually, I'm the writer of The Matrix and Terminator, and the only writer of The Matrix and Terminator. What happened was they used my script treatment called The Third Eye in a manuscript, and characters, special effects, graphics, the makings of The Third Eye, which also became the makings of The Matrix. So they used my entire work. So I am definitely the author of The Matrix and Terminator. In fact, the first Matrix was created from a storyboard, like a comic book. 500 to 600 drawings was made from my work and all the characters, and the majority of the special effects and graphics come from me. The only one that didn't come from me was the bullet time, but the rest came from me, and all the special effects that was in the Terminator came from me, and not Stan Winston. Yeah, go ahead.
You sent me the form, the copyright form, which was 1981, and The Terminator came out, I believe, in the late 80s, mid to late 80s. What did you, and when those movies came out, did you see it, or did someone tell you about it? How did that whole situation transpire?
Well, The Terminator came out actually October of 1984. And I didn't know anything about The Terminator at all. What happened was I discovered the theft of The Matrix March the 31st, 1999, during the national release. And when I went to the FBI and they started investigating, they're the ones that told me in 2000, 2001, that not only had I written The Matrix, but I also wrote The Terminator also. At the time during The Terminator, I was married and pregnant with a baby, so I wasn't even going to the movies at that time. So that's why I didn't know anything about The Terminator. But I was going to the movies in 1999. And so The Terminator is actually the prequels of The Matrix, and Sarah Connor is actually Neo's mother. The Terminator goes right into The Matrix, and The Matrix is the future of the science fiction epic. In other words, John Connor's JC, Jesus Christ, is equal to Neo, one and the same. Because what I wrote was The Evolutions of Consciousness, the Second Coming of Christ, not the First Coming of Christ, which is in the Bible, and Man versus Machine. In other words, Christ is going to come back, born of a woman, and grow up to take out the technology or the machines in the future. And that's what the whole epic story is about. It's the path of Neo or the journey of the one or, you know, vice versa. Because Matrix is Latin for womb. And the Bible, in Exodus 34, chapter 19, verse, God says, he who opens the matrix of mind, meaning that all the children born coming from the womb receive the soul, and they are his children. But then man starts creating his own children, mankind, or a kind of man, but not born with souls. They were soulless machines. They were petri dish, cloning, test tube babies, artificial insemination. Because God is saying that the only way you can receive the soul is coming through the womb, the natural process of having a baby, not creating babies in test tubes, not creating babies in petri dishes, and not creating them in a lab and then putting them, inserting them in the womb of a woman. Or cloning, which is just dividing and separating the atom, A-T-O-M, not the Adama. When you split the atom to the right, you create clones, life, bodies, physical bodies, but born without souls, which will become machines because they have no compassion, no empathy, no love. Whenever you split the atom, which is the A-T-O-M, the atom, to the left, you create the atomic bomb. You create death or the nuclear bomb, neutrons, protons, electrons. And a lot of people don't realize that everything is polarity, polar, that there is no duality, that the philosopher Descartes confused the masses with algebra and deception because duality is claiming there are two things going on, that there is a devil versus God or a devil as powerful as God that's warring with God, which is a lie because God created everything, and if God created everything, if he created the devil, then the devil is subjected to him. He's not greater, or he's not an equal. So therefore, there can only be one, and that is God, and everything goes back to the one. There are only nine numbers in the universe, and everything goes back to the one. The one is the Alpha, nine is the Omega. There's no such thing as 10, because one plus zero, zero is the infinity. So 1 plus 0 is equal to 1, so everything goes back to the 1. There's no such thing as 11. 1 plus 1 is 2. 12. 1 plus 2 is 3. So all of these numbers go back to the basis 1 through 9, and it begins again on 1, meaning that if you start out in one spot, you'll end up in that same place, a complete cycle or circle, 360 degrees, which is 360 is just a 9. Meaning that after 9, it goes back to the 1. And the 0 is infinity. That's God's number. If you look at the number 8, you'll see the two little zeros that goes on and on and on. If you lay those 8 vertically or horizontal, there's nothing but zeros. That means God is infinity. He goes on and on forever. There's no beginning to him, no end. He just continues forever.
We're talking to Sophia Stewart, mother of the Matrix. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. I'm your host, Sean Anthony. And of course, if you like to call in and ask questions to Sophia, the number is toll free, 877-300-7645. That's 877-300-7645. Or follow me on Twitter and shoot me a tweet, a question on Twitter at Sean_Anthony. Sophia, you wrote this book back in 1980, or this treatment. What inspired you to write such a complex story back then that it was so futuristic?
First of all, I'd like people to know that they should go to my website and look at my website, MatrixTerminator.com. There's Matrix 4 book and the Third Eye book. They can read this, you know, for themselves. And then I'd like to say, not only did I write a script treatment, again, I wrote a script treatment plus a manuscript, a 47-page manuscript in a script treatment with characters, graphics, and special effects and so forth. And I was inspired by God. That was my inspiration. And how was I inspired? How did I get this inspiration? Well, I saw Star Wars in the late 70s, and I recognized George Lucas's concept that he was talking about Darth Vader was the devil. He's talking about how the devil fell from the light side to the dark. And I was quite amazed by that. I wasn't inspired by Star Wars. I was quite amazed that someone had put the point of view of Satan on the screen, and they had done it up in science fiction form. Then I got to thinking that what about Christ? Because in Revelation they said he was going to come back. And I got to thinking about that. Why don't I do a Christ story, the one? You know, because Matrix is mentioned 5 times in the King James Bible. It means Latin for womb. So what if Christ came back born of a woman? That's what I was thinking about. And what would he be doing in the future?
Well, let's stay right there. Sophia Stewart is our guest, the mother of the Matrix. We're going to talk more about the future and Matrix 4, plus your comments. 877-300-7645 is the number to call in. I'm Sean Anthony. You're listening to Flow of Wisdom Radio.
Stop letting corporate news tell lies to your children. Flow like the blood of Abraham.
Born March 6, 1972. 325 pounds. 7 feet 1 inch. Shoe size 23. 15-time All-Star, 19 years pro, and future Hall of Famer, unveils a new chapter in his legacy. Forever K. Michael presents Shaquille O'Neal's Dunkman Eyewear. Powerful, distinctive, strength, confident, bold. Eyewear. Forever K. Michael presents Shaquille O'Neal's Dunkman Eyewear. Available now.
And we'll bring you out the darkness. Sweet King Martin.
So glad for you to be here joining us live on the Genesis Communications Radio Network. And shouts out to everybody listening across the globe on GCNLive.com. And my guest today is Sophia Stewart, who is the mother of the Matrix, the writer of the Matrix and the Terminator. And those films have become sort of like a cult classic. And, you know, Ms. Stewart, you've been going through some ups and downs and challenges in the judicial department with all of these legal battles that's going on. I understand you had a $150 million settlement awarded towards you. Can you elaborate on that?
Yeah, I want to clarify that a lot of people, you know, snoops, they got old information, and they're not really, whenever someone tries to correct them. They've never interviewed me, and they're telling a lot of lies on there that I didn't show up for my court case. I've been involved in like 3 court cases. My first court case was 2000/2004, which was compromised by my 4 attorneys. It was actually sabotage. One of others, I sent them to sabotage the case because I was going to get them on RICO because it was criminal copyright infringement. And the Wachowski brothers and Warner Brothers never answered the amended complaint. They lost on a default judgment. The other Terminator defendants were adjudicated because my former attorneys committed fraud, and they never entered my evidence that came from the FBI. They were told to subpoena the evidence, and they never entered the evidence. And that's how the case got shut down, and the judge couldn't have or shouldn't have, because she worked with Warner Brothers. She should have recused herself. A lot of my former attorneys that worked with Warner Brothers, they should have never came on the case. So it was all complicit and conspiracy, and they've been hiding this in the media. This is why the media never covered the case, and they covered it up. And then I filed a 2007 case against the former 4 attorneys in Utah. That was my second case, and I won $150 million-plus judgment. The damages could exceed up to $1.8 billion against the lead attorney, Jonathan LaBelle, who had committed fraud. He had got disbarred in 1993, and I'm still involved in that case right now over in Utah, and I'll come back to that in a minute. And I want to tell people about a third court case that I have here in Nevada, which was filed on November 1st, 2012. Against Andy and Larry Wachowski, Warner Brothers, for fraud on the movie Cloud Atlas, then calling themselves the creator, because they was calling themselves the directors and the writers, and then they stopped that because they know that I was the writer, because my book, The Third Eye, was adapted in the script, my script treatment, and it's all in the introductions of all the movies, Matrix and Terminator, plus the Anti-Matrix. So it's undisputed who the writer is. But on my second case, I just won this major judgment, and they're not talking about it. And the media is not covering it because the judges over there, one of them has recused himself, and another judge, Judge D. Benson, won't even get on the case because it's fraud, and it's due process violations, criminal fraud and due process. Now, one of the judges, Judge Evelyn First, she should have recused herself, but she's still trying to carry out the fraud. She's very complicit. I'm going to have to file criminal charges against her. And one of the defendants, Barry Brown, has admitted under oath that he and Judge Nerfler, another judge on the case, which was a magistrate judge at the time, but now he's become a federal judge, and that's in question because he has no right to become a federal judge after fixing a case. He and the defendant and my former attorney, which was court-ordered off the case, all 3 of them fixed the case against me. And the defendant, Gary Brown, admitted this under oath in an affidavit. And that's when Judge Wadoff, another judge, federal judge on the case, recused himself, and Judge Benson got off. They just shut the whole case down in Utah on December the 11th, 2012. I just got in the mail from Judge Evelyn First. Just on May the 8th, she's made some rulings. She has denied all of my motions, including a phenomenal de novo show cause hearing where all the defendants must appear because the court case has been going on for 5 years. 5 years, the oldest court case in Utah history, and these people have never set foot in there.
Sophia Stewart, my guest.
I'm the only one that's been coming to my hearing.
Hang on, Sophia. I want you to finish up, and I want to ask you some other questions pertaining to these legal issues. You are listening to Flow of Wisdom Radio with Sean Anthony. We'll be right back.
Flow of Wisdom Books presents Conversations with Hip Hop by Sean Anthony. Readers are calling this high-impact e-book straightforward. It's a glimpse of Anthony on and off the air. Conversations with Hip Hop is a brilliant compilation. It addresses real and unspoken issues affecting people and communities. Experience the promise of hope that change can come sooner than expected, beginning with us.
Be sure to download my brand new book, Conversations with Hip Hop, right now on Amazon.com. On sale for only 99 cents for a limited time. Conversations with Hip Hop, available now on Amazon.com.
I see the questions coming in. I see the text messages, people hitting me up personally, the chats and all of that good stuff. Welcome back. Flow of Wisdom Radio. I'm your host, Sean Anthony. My guest, Sophia Stewart, known as the mother of the Matrix, the creator, the writer of the Matrix. Her story was implemented in those two mega films. And we were just talking before we went to break. Sophia, you said you won a settlement of $150 million. Real quick, just how did your life change after that? And I know you're still going through legal battles, but it's not often that everyone, you know, wins $150 million in legal settlements.
Yeah, well, I won $150 million plus. I mean, that I can tally, once I tally up the damages, once my attorneys come in and tally up the damages, it could exceed up to $1.8 billion. Because these former lawyers committed criminal fraud. You see, this everything is not a civil case. The 2004 case in California, the 2007 case in Utah, and the 2012 case here in Las Vegas, they're all criminal. It's criminal fraud and stuff, and it's cover-up, and the government has been participating partially in this fraud. Now, I received the Matrix and Terminator copyright, so I own the Matrix and Terminator, and I'm the one that can continue Matrix and Terminator. That's already been decided by the government because the government does not want to participate in a unlawful monopoly and breaking the antitrust the antitrust violations, which is a restraint of trade under the Sherman Act.
Let me ask you real quick, Sophia, real quick before you move on, because I think you said some things that I think are rather important. You own the copyrights to The Matrix and The Terminator, and I've seen it. As a matter of fact, the documents, I posted links to everything, the PDFs of the court cases and everything on flowofwisdom.com. Her website as well is called truthaboutmatrix.com. Let me ask you this. Do you receive residuals or royalties now from everything that was made prior to these court battles?
Well, that's what I'm trying to explain to people, that once I go in and my attorneys come in and tally up the damages and start making the amends, because, see, the government has to come in and make some of these amends also, because I'm the only one that that the trademarks belong to, Matrix and Terminator. Now, one of the lawyers, Jeffrey D. Ford, he's been compromised and bought out by Warner Brothers. He's blocking my Matrix trademark with my own derivatives. One of the derivatives that he's using to block my trademark with is Enter the Matrix, a video game. And what happened was Warner Brothers came in there and they got canceled out on all the trademarks that they got illegally. They got canceled out on the Matrix movie, 1999 movies, the characters, the games, everything, merchandising and so forth. On June the 13th, 2012, and I can show the documents of proof to anybody. I can show them the judgment award and so forth. The Warner Brothers and the Wachowski brothers never had any copyrights. The Wachowski brothers never wrote anything. They never assigned anything to Warner Brothers because they never had anything. They pulled the Houdini and a Milli Vanilli on you guys. They pulled the Houdini and a Milli Vanilli, and the government shut them down and gave me the copyrights. Now, let me tell you something, everybody. I'm in the World Book of Guinness, or should be in there, because when I applied for the Terminator copyrights, I applied on February the 7th, 2013, and the government gave them to me on February the 8th, 2013. So fastest anybody's ever gotten a copyright.
You ain't never lied about that. That is quick. That is quick. We're talking to Sophia Stewart, the mother of the Matrix. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. I'm your host, Sean Anthony. And we have, let's take some phone calls, Sophia. Ramon in Miami has a question for you. Ramon, welcome to Flow of Wisdom Radio.
What's going on? I appreciate it, Sean. How you doing, Ms. Stewart?
Yo, fine. Thank you.
Okay, my question for you is, first things first, are you familiar with the story of Haru, Osiris, and Isis of Egypt?
Yes, I am. It goes back to ancient Egypt, Osiris and Haru, the right eye and the left eye. Amun-Ra was the left eye, and Haru was the right eye, and they were the right eye of God. I'm very familiar with it. My work, when people get my book, The Third Eye, they will see all of this in my work. That's what you see in The Matrix, which they're calling mythology, and in spirituality and different religious symbolism. So I'm very much, when you read my book, I go back and I'm talking about the Illuminati's, I'm talking about the Federal Reserve, the Trilateral Commissions, the Almighty Dollar. I'm talking about 30 years ago, all of this 30 years ago. I'm the one talking about digital downloading, barcodes, scanners that you're using now to scan your food. I'm talking about it 30 years ago. I'm talking about computerized warfare with the drones, where Trinity tells tanks, download me so I can fly this helicopter. I'm a visionary seer like Tesla and Nostradamus and Leonardo da Vinci, those guys. My grandmother's full-blooded native. My father's Spanish. So it's in my bloodline, my DNA, who I am. I'm a New Yorker. When you get the book, it's undisputed.
Does that answer your question, Ramon? I'm sorry.
It definitely answered my question. And the reason why I asked that is because, as you can tell from my Twitter name, my YouTube name, it's Truth Quest 305. I'm located in the 305 in Miami. And the reason why I refer to it as the Truth Quest, a brand that I'm trying to build, is because even though I've acquired a lot of knowledge and a lot of wisdom, I've read a lot about different religions and different history, and now that I've finally, I didn't even know about you, to be honest, but now that I do know, I'll go back and get your old books and your new book and, read up on you as well, because obviously, you're one of those pioneers who were foreseeing in the future, and you use your talents in writing and literature to foresee that and try to help us, acquire knowledge and use that to better ourselves every day. But the reason why I brought up the whole Haru and Osiris thing is because I've noticed a lot of people, where I'm from anyways, aren't even familiar with ancient Egypt. They don't even know Egypt is in Africa. I've gone to a lot of people throughout my hood and asked them, like, yo, do you know where Egypt is at? And they're like, yeah, in the Middle East. Hey, that's where them Arabs at? And I'm like, yeah. It's hard to explain to them to get them. And the reason why I say that is this is because I notice a lot of people in our culture, in the ghetto, in the hood throughout the world, they don't really have knowledge of self, they don't even know the story of Haru and Osiris and how it pertains to their spirituality and God, and I don't knock anybody for being Christian or believing in Jesus, but I just, I try to ask people, how deep does your research go? Do you just stop at King James and just, believe that's all there is to it, or do you try to go deep?
Sophia, go ahead and respond.
Believe me, I go deep. Once you read the book, you'll see. I go all the way to ancient Egypt and the mysteries and the mystery school of devices. I know all about it. It's in my book, the work. I take people there. The symbolisms of ancient Egypt, it's all in my book. When you see the graphics and everything, believe me, the astrology, numerology, I'll take everybody back to the foreign land. This is the thing, Ramon. The government have just made it mandatory for Black history to be in all the schools. Now the black schools have complied with that mandate. The white schools have not, and that's where this ignorance lies. Ignorance is not a bad word. It's just simply ignoring facts you should know. And a lot of people don't know facts, and that's why people take advantage of them, because they don't know the law. They don't know their history. They don't know thyself, like in the pyramids. Over the pyramids, it said, know thyself. And when you don't know yourself, then you are taken. And this is what's going on, all this cover-up and hidden and stuff, and the masses hanging out and being ignorant of what's going on. You can fleece any sheep if he doesn't pay any attention. A wolf will come along and wolf and eat him up.
We're talking to Sophia Stewart, our guest. Sophia, we have some other questions. Thanks for the call, Ramon. We appreciate it. 877-300-7645. That's toll-free, 877-300-7645. If you have questions for Sophia Stewart, the mother of the Matrix. On Twitter, at Mimi Says, is asking, why did God choose you to have your gift, Sophia?
I feel like that God, he uses anybody. He can use any vessel that's willing to be in obedience. And I just feel that God gave me that inspiration, gave me that story that is global. That story is not a little simple story that these people are lying and said in Hollywood. James Cameron and Andy and Larry Wachowski don't even know what Matrix and Terminator really is. And there's no way in the world they could have written it because they don't know what it is, and that's why you don't see them being interviewed. This work is a spiritual. It is beyond race, color, creed, nationality. It's global. Every race, color, creed, nationality, Chinese, Russians, the Koreans, Australia, London. This work is sought after around the world. How do I know? Because people are going on my website, MatrixTerminator.com, one word, and buying Matrix 4 books globally, and the Third Eye book, TruthAboutMatrix.com. So this is sought after. This applies to everybody. It's a message to the world. Everybody loves Matrix and Terminator. And Matrix movie is going to come because this is what people want. You give the people what they want. Everybody identify with it because it's a spiritual message. It's encrypted, encoded in numbers. And if you go in the Bible and you forget about the words there, if you look, God is speaking in sacred ancient geometry. God's language is the numbers. Look at the Exodus, 34th chapter, 19th verse. These are codes, and the scriptures are encoded. They're parables. You have to, break the codes to understand what God's language is. God's language is mathematics. Math is the greatest language, universal language around the world, not these words and language that people call nationalities and stuff. Those are labels. The universal language is mathematics.
Real quick, Sophia, because we got about 60 seconds until we go to break, but I want to know, the Wachowski brothers, they have a gag order. Can you say briefly, what is it that they cannot speak about?
Well, if people look at their first interview, which I can give to people, they're telling on themselves. They're saying that they never wrote the Matrix, that they drew it up on a storyboard. You're actually admitting it. And they also can't even answer the questions. The people who are interviewing them are asking them phenomenal questions, and they don't even know what they're talking about.
Stay right there. Sophia Stewart, we got to go to a commercial break, and I want you to finish up. And if you have questions, call in 877-300-7645. We're talking to the mother of the Matrix on Flow of Wisdom Radio.
Imagine going up to 100,000 miles without ever getting an oil change. Hi, I'm Sean Anthony, host of Flow of Wisdom Radio, and I am proud to present Filch Oil, a company that is dedicated to extending the life of your oil. Here's Jeremy Lehman, president of Filch Oil, Inc.
It's a brand new patented technology. It's absolutely fantastic because it's green. It helps customers extend the life of their engine oil, whether they have a gasoline vehicle or one that runs off of diesel. Either way, we've got a product that can add it onto their engine that supplements the inline filtration that allows them to take out oxidation products and moisture and extend the life of the oil easily 2 times. But what we are finding is that we've seen customers go 100,000 miles without changing their oil.
Call filchoil.com today to extend the life of your oil. 1-800-638-3866. Mention promo code Sean. Filchoil.com. 1-800-638-3866. Mention promo code Sean. That's filchoil.com at 1-800-638-3866. Use promo code Sean.
Back
Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony, and I appreciate the tweets that's coming in. Follow me on Twitter at Sean_Anthony. I'm shooting out all the links so that you can get the information to get the new book, Matrix 4, from Sophia Stewart, known as the mother of the Matrix. And we got about 5 minutes till this break, till we go to the top of the hour. The next hour, Sophia, I want to just focus on the Matrix 4 and the future. But before we went to break, we were talking about the Wachowskis. Now, the Wachowski brothers are the guys that directed the Matrix film, and now one of them turned into a woman. So they're not even known as the Wachowski brothers. They're just known as the Wachowskis. But I was asking you, Sophia, about the gag order that was placed on them, and you was going on to explain.
Yeah, like I was saying before, the interviewers asked them, well, how did you write The Matrix? You know, and they said, that, you know, what was your inspiration? How did you come up with it? And they both answered that they saw a lot of kung fu movies. That was their answer. They both saw a lot of kung fu movies. So people see kung fu movies all day long and can't write The Matrix and Terminator. You know what I'm saying? And they could not answer the big questions. They couldn't answer quantum physics. They couldn't answer that it was the evolutions of consciousness. So they basically told on themselves, and I'll send that email over to you with the Wachowski's first interview. And after that, Warner Brothers gagged them because they were going to tell on themselves there's no way in the world they could go on major TV shows like Ellen or 60 Minutes or Diane Sawyer or Barbara Walters without having a lawyer present to guide them. And then everybody would know it's a criminal, they committed a criminal offense, theft. Because at the end of the day, that's what it all boils down to. This is all criminal. It should have never gone to court. When I took it to court in 2003/4, I had asked the judge, Judge Terry J. Hatter, to order RICO served on them because the U.S. Attorney's Office in Salt Lake City, Greg Diamond and Elizabeth Ann Stevens, Greg Diamond, they had prosecutor over there. They were supposed to prosecute the Matrix case because they're the ones that initiated the investigations through the FBI. Well, they got bought off. They got bought off from prosecuting. And then Warner Brothers involved so many people in the theft that senators and politicians and contractors, all of them are aiding and abetting in RICO. And complicit judges, lawyers, it's just crazy now.
That's
money laundering, you know, wire fraud, mail fraud, and it's going across interstate. So huge now that some people are going to have to end up going to jail because they thought that they could cover it up and it'd go away. But it's not going away because the people are interested in it.
That's right. And the truth will always shine through.
Exactly. And I've become a huge international internet star globally because of this. The foreign countries, the people in the foreign countries, they know what's going on in America. And they know that the government failed to protect my copyrights. There's nowhere in the world that Judge Morrow, which is one of the people who work with Warner Brothers, could have shut the case down in 2004 with the FBI holding the evidence. See, the case had already been investigated by the evidence, and theft had been found on it. It's in my book, the Third Eye book. Buy the book on my website, matrixterminator.com, truthaboutmatrix.com, and see for yourself. You can see the FBI validating the theft. You can see them admitting to the judge, the Terminator defendants, that they stole the Terminator from me, and they wanted the judge to shut the case down on the statutes of limitations. They cited the James Bond case, because they had stolen the franchise from the real James Bond writer. He sat on his right, and they stole the franchise. They tried to use the same thing with the judge on my case, and the judge said to admit that theft is willful intent, that the clock starts ticking the moment the victim discovers the theft, not when you commit the act of theft. See, they didn't understand the law, and that they were admitting. See, she should have reported that on the title 18 U.S.C. 4. 2-3
Well, stay right there. Sophia Stewart, we got to wrap up this hour. I see the phone calls coming in. Ellis in New York, I got you. Mackay in Ohio, I got you. We're going to take a quick break, and then hour number two with the mother of the Matrix, Sophia Stewart, and we're going to talk about Matrix 4. I'm Sean Anthony. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio.